Chapter 24, Modern Science. The scientists of each generation are delivered by the mind factory that is mainstream education. They already have a perception of reality based on what they have been told is real since their first day at school. They have to pass exams in their specialization and conform to orthodoxy to pass them, and the funding only comes if they stick to the song sheet throughout their careers. This is a quote by David Icke from The Perception Deception. Science can be easily fabricated, and I believe that it currently is being, and has been for a very long time. Answers given from science or religion are deemed to be the pinnacles of information, and this is why they have literally crossed paths from time to time. It is said that science and or religion holds all life's answers. They do not. Jim Mars wrote in one of his books entitled Our Occult History, that their wealthy control scientific research and woe be tied to those who attempt to argue against conventional thinking, and according to many independent researchers, there appears to be a conspiracy against any discovery that conflicts with prevailing wisdom, and he gave the following example. Consider the fate of Thomas Ely of the National Museum of Canada. In the early 50s, he discovered sophisticated stone tools caught in ice on Manitoulin Island in Lake Huron. The tools were proven to be at least 65,000 years old and maybe even 125,000 years, totally contradicting conventional theories concerning the date that such well-fashioned stone tools were first created. Following his discovery, he claimed that he was hounded from his position, his work was misrepresented, and nobody would publish his findings. Most of his artifacts vanished into storage bins, and the museum director was fired for refusing to discharge Lee. Jim Mars wrote that unfortunately this case was far from isolated. He highlights comments from authors Cremo and Thompson, who wrote a book entitled Forbidden Archaeology. They say that there exists in the scientific community a knowledge filter that screens out unwelcome evidence. This process of knowledge filtration has been going on for well over a century and continues right up to the present day. This time it is the creed of scientism and the pseudo-religion of the Big Bang that stands in the way of progress. In truth, we have no relative understanding of matter, light, magnetism, gravity, quantum behavior, subatomic particles, stars, galaxies, or, need I go on, stories of creation and what did and did not happen in the universe over the past 13.7 billion years are crackpot schemes by celebrities of less talent than many in the Natural Philosophy Alliance but of greater prestige. We have too much information and too little understanding. Many of the things we are taught just ain't so. This realization frees the mind to view everything afresh. It is the spark required to rekindle enthusiasm for science and drive progress. There is so much to be discovered. This is a quote by Walt Thornhill. Another researcher wrote that realize that scientific institutions, such as the Smithsonian and the National Geographic Society, are set up by the world's elite factions in the first place to either debunk, distort or simply ignore any scientific data that tends to enlighten people about their true origins. Michael Cremo said that he saw in science evidence of both misfeasance and malpractice. Cremo cited words from a young paleontologist and expert on whale bones from the Museum of Natural History in San Diego when he said, "I tend to stay away from anything that has to do with humans because it's just too controversial." Jim Mars go on to say that the record indicates a conscious effort to derail true scientific investigation by a clique of wealthy and powerful people, and cites anthropologist Kevin Jones Kern from Bowling Green State University, who says that for a brief period in the late 1920s and early 1930s, Rockefeller philanthropies flirted with, and ultimately abandoned, the field of anthropology. During those crucial years and through their modest grants, however, they dramatically affected the course of anthropology. Science is not the only form of knowledge, it is true. It is also true that science is not necessarily neutral. Many times it conceals ideological views or economic interests. This is a quote by Pope Francis, February 2017. Jim Mars states that the Rockefellers, along with other wealthy, elite American families such as the Mellons, Carnegies and Gettys, gained unequaled control over many of America's universities through direct grants and through foundations. After World War II, the funds dried up and inevitably less scientific jobs were available and fewer funded opportunities for fieldwork. Those that found work became limited in what and how they investigated. The power of such families in scientific studies can be demonstrated in the lists of founding members and presidents of the National Science Board in the U.S., and the governing board of the National Science Foundation, whose members serve as policy advisors to the U.S. Congress and the President. They included in 2013, Chester A. Barnard Rockefeller Foundation, Detlev W. Bronk, Rockefeller University, Charles Dolard, Carnegie Corporation of NY, and H. Guyford Stever, Carnegie Mellon University. As many as 12 Rothschild Fellowships are awarded each year in the natural, exact or life sciences and engineering, and up to 8 in the humanities and social sciences. When you witness the words on the mainstream controlled media, a new study shows, bear in mind how easy it now is to manipulate figures. An article written by 538.com found that in trying to explain p-hacking, there was a software program that allows the creator to p-hack their own theoretical scientific study using statistics, which enables scientific researchers to adjust their numbers. A p-value is considered as a function of observed sample results that are quantified in a statistical mode. For the majority of scientific journals, one of their only standards for publication is a statistical p-value of 0.05 or lower. So p-hacking is a popular term to describe how a researcher can take their data and shuffle categories, cross-reference, reorder, etc., with the intention of achieving some kind of statistical correlation to their hypothesis. Such studies are never verified by other scientists, as they have their own studies to conduct or p-hack, and there is also pressure to produce results due to the funding pressures. The downfall of science is upon us, eroded by the intellectual dishonesty of those who promote GMOs, pesticides, vaccines and fluoride in the name of science. The reputation of science itself has lost tremendous ground over the last few years. Even though I am scientifically educated, I believe today's misappropriation of science for corporate greed is perhaps the most destructive, pathological force that has yet been unleashed upon human civilization. This is a quote by Mike Adams, Natural News.